Our lesson this week is on desire, following the thread of desire. In this lesson, we will address the very nature of desire itself. We will address what it means, what it signifies, and how it creates effects in our lives. We'll also address the power of desire, the value of it, the meaning and purpose of desire, and how to begin to bring that energy, which at times feels like it's divided and going in a whole bunch of different directions, under your consciousness and under your deliberate direction, so that you might create as the Father created you, as you were created, with perfect, deliberate, and infinite love, with perfect, infinite, and deliberate joy, and with perfect, perfect freedom. I just want to take a minute to say thank you for all your kind messages, and it is my desire to continue to do what I'm doing and work as a spiritual guide or a spiritual mentor. I just wanted to take a moment before we start to say thank you to everyone for your wonderful messages. They are very encouraging to me. When I first started doing this, I was very nervous, and I'm starting to feel more relaxed and confident and following the thread of my own desire. I also want to say thank you to the people that left messages that weren't very kind. Everyone has the right to feel the way they do, and I'm sure that your expression will help you on your path somehow. So, I want you to listen very carefully to this message because it's very important. Think this. You are a wave arising from the infinite ocean, the ocean of love that is the presence of God. I am a wave that has arisen from the ocean of the holy mind of our Creator. And though two waves seem to appear separate by what is called time, they arise for the very same purpose, to express the simplicity, the innocence, the beauty, the creativity, the truth, and the reality of the ocean itself. The waves delight in expressing what seems to be a unique individuality, yet they carry the common thread of being made of the same substance and are truly governed by the same laws of creation. They don't know the moment of their own arising, for only the depth of the ocean, unseen, can know the moment when it chooses to well up to create the expression of each individual wave. The power that is not seen is hidden in the depth of the ocean. As the ocean rises up and forms that wave, that individual wave, and sustains it throughout the duration of its expression, is my life, and it's your life. Or I should say, a symbolic of your life and my life. It is from the same depth of that ocean that it is decided when that wave shall return into the sea. Does that mean that it disappears? Only from one perspective. But in reality, the very substance that was made manifest truly has not known birth or death, but only expression. What if you were to consider yourself as a wave arising from the holy mind of God, born of God's infinite desire to expand herself or himself or itself, to express the infinite nature of love and of creativity? What if you began to realize that all you have called to yourself is the effect of love, and that you did not cause yourself to come into this existence? you and I must find our own way to our own truths. For before each and every one of us, each and every one of you, lies your pathway, a doorway, an eye of a needle. And through that eye, only you can pass, only you can fit. Therefore, in some respects, you are seemingly alone. You must make the decision to desire above all things. Awakening into perfect remembrance of your union with God. Just as a wave might finally decide that it has been birthed, not fearful of being a wave, but truly claim its individualness, its individuation, its unique, and to live that fully.